Good morning. Which has more mass, steel or wood?
Flippin' physics.
Steel is more massive than wood, right?
I would think so.
Funny.
I mean, steel feels heavier than wood, so...
It is a bad question.
Why?
You cannot say which is more massive without knowing the sizes of the objects.
Oh, right.
Thank you, Billy. This steel sphere, which has a mass of 68 grams, actually is less massive than this block of wood, which has a mass of 522 grams. So this block of wood is more massive than this steel sphere. However, the two objects are of completely different sizes. When we look at two spheres of equal diameter, the steel sphere has a mass of 535 grams, and the wood sphere has a mass of 45 grams. So clearly, when the two objects are the same size, the steel object is more massive than the wood object. Typically, people tend to think of steel as being more massive than wood, which, as Billy pointed out, is impossible to know without knowing the sizes of the objects. However, we do know that steel has a larger density than wood.
Oh, yeah. I tend to confuse density and mass.
And mass and weight.
Yeah.
Which is why we did that whole lesson on the differences between weight and mass.
Yep. Density equals mass divided by volume. The symbol for density is the lowercase Greek letter rho, and it looks like a curly lowercase p. And density is a material property of any pure substance. In other words, the density of pure copper is 8.96 grams per centimeter cubed, and any object made of pure copper, regardless of size, will have that same density of 8.96 grams per centimeter cubed.
Assuming the copper object is at room temperature and atmospheric pressure, right?
That is correct. However, for liquids and solids, the effects of temperature and pressure on density are quite small. But yeah, it is important to realize density does change depending on temperature and pressure. Thanks, Bobby.
You are welcome, Mr. P.
Let's calculate the densities of the two equal diameter spheres. Both have a diameter of 50.7 millimeters. Billy, please determine their volumes in cubic centimeters.
Well, as you just pointed out, they both have the same diameter, so both spheres will have the same volume as well. The volume of a sphere equals 4/3 pi times radius cubed, and radius equals diameter divided by 2, so the radius of both spheres is 50.7 millimeters divided by 2, or 25.35 millimeters. There are 10 millimeters in every centimeter, so multiply the radius, or 25.35 millimeters, by 1 centimeter divided by 10 millimeters, and we get 2.535 centimeters for the radius. So the volume of both spheres equals 4/3 times pi times the cube of 2.535 centimeters, or 68.2374 centimeters cubed for the volume of the steel sphere and the volume of the wood sphere.
Thank you, Billy. Bo, please determine the densities of the steel and wood spheres.
Sure. Density equals mass over volume. So the density of the steel sphere equals the mass of the steel sphere over the volume of the steel sphere, or 535 grams over 68.2374 cubic centimeters, which equals 7.84027, or approximately 7.84 grams per cubic centimeter. And the density of the wood sphere equals the mass of the wood sphere over the volume of the wood sphere, or 45 grams over the same volume, which equals 0.65946, or approximately 0.66 grams per cubic centimeter.
Great. Thank you, Bo. Now, both of these observed values for density make sense because they are within the range of the accepted values for those densities. The accepted value for the density of steel is roughly 7.7 to 8.0 grams per centimeter cubed. And the accepted value for the density of this type of wood, which is birch, is in the range of 0.5 to 0.8 grams per centimeter cubed. So yeah, both of the observed values we determined for density are within the range of the accepted values. And you can clearly see that the density of steel is larger than the density of wood.
Mr. P?
Yes, Bobby?
Why is the accepted value for the density of birch wood a wider relative range than the relative range for the accepted value for the density of steel?
Oh, I bet that is because steel is a lot more consistent of a material, whereas birch wood has a lot more variance in it. I mean, birch wood is grown in nature as trees, and steel is made by humans. Basically, steel is an alloy made by adding a little bit of carbon to iron ore. You can't just dig up steel from the ground.
You can in Minecraft.
But only after the redstone update.
Minecraft is not real life.
Speak for yourself.
Yeah.
Billy, thank you for clarifying that. I just want to return for a moment to the original question. Which has more mass, steel or wood? Bobby, how would you answer that question now?
I would say steel has a larger density than wood, which means steel has a larger mass per unit volume than wood. So given the same volume, a steel object has more mass than a wood object.
I like that answer. Thanks.
I still think it is a bad question.
Yeah, but Bobby gave a good answer. Thank you for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.